Hey there, how you doing? My name is Shala and I'm here to introduce this promotional video, which is a production of Village Baptist Church. Now the aim of this video is to give you a little bit of information about some of the ministries we have at our church and what you might experience if you were to come and visit us in person. So thank you and enjoy.
Village Baptist Church exists to win people to Christ and develop them into active disciples, equipping them to serve as ministers in the church community and around the world, leading them to worship God in spirit and in truth.
Here at Village Baptist Church, we believe worship is a very important part of the Christian life and the life of the church. Worship is a time when the church comes together as one, and with one voice, on one accord, we proclaim and declare the character and the greatness of God. At Village, we use the Bible as our guide as to what worship should look like, and Scripture tells us that singing, shouting, dancing, instruments, praying, bowing, the lifting of hands, and clapping are all ways to worship God, and we do and encourage all of these things. Our end goal in worship is that Christ be glorified and that we would all grow individually as a church in our relationship with Him through worship. In Christ, there is freedom and joy and true love. And our hearts in the worship ministry is that you would be free to worship, experience joy in worship, and that God's love for you would fuel your worship. So if you want to come and experience the presence of God, we encourage you to come and check it out on Sunday mornings at 9 in Petaluma and 11 in Marin City.
It is our pleasure to share with you that each month, Village Baptist Church has a free food ministry. Every month, on the third Saturday of the month, we provide free food to the community and anyone in need. It is our hope and desire to be an example of God's teaching, to care and share with those who are in need.
Sunday school at Village is really unique because it provides an intimate setting where you can grow deeper in your knowledge of God's Word. We cover a variety of topics from salvation, to marriage, to grief, to discipleship. The teachers do a great job of applying the Scriptures to our daily lives. Just by spending that 1 hour on Sunday mornings with other believers dissecting God's Word together, I am more encouraged to read the Word on my own and to share it with others.
Hi, we're from Village Baptist Church, and we're going to tell you about our children's ministry.
In the children's ministry, we have lots of fun while learning the Bible at the same time.
We have children's church, children's Sunday school, and children's soccer. In all of these, we learn a lot.
It's never boring in children's ministry because we also have a Wii and Xbox to have extra, extra fun.
And that's our children's ministry.
See you here.
My name is Jacqueline Santini, and I go to Village Baptist Church. I was born and raised in San Francisco, and I am under Coit Tower. I was very sports directed. I liked sports, lots of sports. And also I was very daring as a kid. I still am. There was a bungee jump 7 stories high. And the 2 young people with me didn't want to go. But so I said, okay, I'll go by myself. And then they said, well, maybe we'll go with you. They didn't have any money, so I lent them the money and we went. And it was marvelous. It was such a thrill. You drop down and go right over the whole park. You could see the whole park. You just swing back and forth. Oh, it was wonderful. I loved it. And I went on all the rides. I love the rides. Also, I used to teach motorcycle safety. I've taught motorcycle safety for 10 years. And I had my own motorcycle. I had even a trailer on the back when I used to go camping. I used to have a little trailer. Yeah. I grew up as a Catholic. My mom and dad didn't go to church, but they made sure we went to church, but they didn't. So that was difficult because I wanted them to go too, but they didn't go on a regular basis. So. Well, I wanted to serve others. I deep inside of me, something kept telling me I wanted to serve other people. And I used to go to catechism, and one of the nuns always told me, when you come to catechism, all the kids come to catechism. When you don't come, nobody comes. Because I used to gather up all the kids and bring them with me to church. And so I took catechism. And so when I didn't go, they didn't go. So she kept telling me that, you make sure you come because then the other kids will come. And so, but I wanted to serve others, and that's why I entered the convent. I worked in San Francisco. I worked in San Jose. And I worked in Mount Shasta. And in Mount Shasta, we did a lot of, I taught catechism. And so when we taught catechism, we brought the kids to, like, they have a lot of old people's homes in that area. And so I used to bring the kids. We used to make things for them, for the older people, and we'd sing for them and all that kind of thing. Most of the teaching I did in the convent was preschool, because our Mother General had started a preschool when the men went off to the gold rush and the women had to work and the kids were on the street. She started daycare, what she called a daycare center. After I came out of the convent in 1970, I went to work with Margaret. I was going to Mass, but not regularly. And something was missing in my life, and I didn't know exactly what it was. And I'd go to Mass, but I wasn't fulfilled. And so I started to pray to the Lord to please bring me to a church where I could be committed and I could go to church all the time, because I knew I should be going to church all the time, but for some reason I just wasn't comfortable going to Mass at the regular Catholic church. So Margaret one day asked me if I wanted to go to Village Baptist. So I did. I went with her. And I liked what I heard, and so I started going to Bible study. I was with Village Baptist Church 2 years before I accepted Christ. And then I accepted Christ, and then it was 2 years later I was baptized. When I went to Village Baptist Church, I felt not only I was interested in what was being taught, but also that there was a loving atmosphere, and that I really enjoyed that, the loving atmosphere. I haven't missed a Sunday since I joined since I first went to Village Baptist Church, except when I've been away on vacation. I am daily in the Word, which in the Catholic Church we really didn't know much about the Bible. They study it, but not the way we do. And so I'm in the Word every day. My prayer life has grown. I have a real relationship with the Lord, which I never had before. And I know He's... The other morning when I was doing my devotional, it was like He was telling me, go slow, it's okay. Read the Word and take it in, and you'll grow. You'll understand it more and more, because I was kind of frustrated not understanding it. And so he just let me know, it's okay. It's going to take time. We'll do it together. And the joy that I've gotten since I've been accepted Christ, it's just the love I have for my church family is, I can't explain it. It's just overwhelming, because I know it's Christ and the Holy Spirit in me. They're just doing marvelous things. Kind of scary sometimes. Stay in the Word and build up your prayer life. And have a prayer life that is all day long. Not just once in a while, but all day long. Think about the Lord and pray to the Lord. And He'll reward you immensely.
Hey guys, listen up. Whatever you may be going through or just getting out of, I know that by watching our shows, you'll be refreshed and empowered and truly entertained by the truth of how God works. You will laugh, cry, and definitely be released from your own life's crazy drama. So come and enjoy our plays, Village Baptist Drama Team Ministry. Experience the drama.
Time you've been in this line. So I'm going to need you to Sabbath and step forward.
I know you did not just tell me to take a sabbatical. Who do you think you are?
I am Deacon Jake Piper. And I have been known to take a fish out of my pocket and slap insolent women with it.
Alright, look here, old
Sabbath.
Man. I will not.
Sabbath.
Tell me the Sabbath one more time. I want to hear it with your mouth. Say Sabbath one more time. I don't hear nothing. Do you hear anything? No. So you can just move your little self to the back of the line. Yeah, excuse me. Move. See, he ain't talking. So you can mind. Just come forward. Come on. Come forward.
Read it. Take it. Read it.
Sabbath. You know what?
I do not have time for nonsense, from trials and tribulations. Excuse me.
Oh no, he did he just touch me? Okay, he got the wrong one, okay?
Excuse me, you guys in line?
Yeah.
Yes, we are.
The church is a family, the family of God. This is a unique family. It's made up of people from Africa, like me, people from Australia, people from Japan, people from South America, people from Idaho.
Bless you, bless you.
Arkansas, Texas. North Carolina, South Carolina, North Dakota, and South Dakota, from everywhere, from even New York City. From everywhere, from Marin City, from Belvedere, from everywhere. People, different kinds of people, white, black, Asian, Hispanic, it doesn't matter. They are made up, and guess what? There is no single one in the church that came into the family of God perfect.
Amen.
And not only that, even when we come into the church, we are still imperfect. We are a family. I'm going somewhere.
Yes, sir.
I, you know, put on your seatbelt because it's going to get a little bit rough. We are the people of God. It doesn't matter what people say about you. It doesn't matter what the world thinks about you. You are still the people of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Jesus said it before Jesse Jackson said it. You are somebody. You've been born again by the Spirit of the living God. You've been brought into His kingdom. And God is not unaware of your imperfections. You know, that's the thing that's good about the church. The church is the family. Let me go a little bit further. You know, the Bible uses, it's really interesting that the Bible uses the phrase, the body of Christ, to describe the church. The church is the body of Christ. Oh, you need to shout about that. The church is the body of Christ, and absolutely nobody in the church, not the pastor, not the pope, not the deacons, not the any officer, cover all of them. No one is the head of the church.
Amen.
There's only one head of the church. His name is not Emmanuel. His name is not Alfreda. His name is Jesus Christ. He is the only head of the church. Thank God that He doesn't rule the church by what you think.
Amen.
He rules the church by His word. He doesn't leave it to us. And that is why it was really great this morning. Actually, I went to Safeway.
Thank you.
And yeah, it was smelling so good, I started eating it in Petaluma. The church is called the body of Christ. And the Bible says we are individually members of it. Let me do this before I get to this. Again, I don't know. I have a few more minutes. But let me tell you, in Romans chapter 12, verses 3 through 8, we are called the body of Christ with many parts. The church never uses the phrase that the church is the nose of Christ. Never. You can search your Bible. You will never find it. The church is not the nose of Christ. The church is not even called the heart of Christ. The church is not called the lungs of Christ. The church is not called the legs of Christ. The church is called the body of Christ. And because the church is called the body of Christ, no single one person is the church. We're just parts. And parts will make up the body. So I went to Safeway while I was, the Lord told me, you need to let people understand what that means. The church is the body of Christ. So I was looking for a bread. Because the reason why I was looking for bread is because Jesus used this as an illustration when He was spending the final time with His disciples. He took bread and broke it And he said, this is my body. And what does he call us? The body of Christ. So I said, that's what we are. We're bread. And there's one thing unique about bread. Let me give you. Somebody came up with what they call sliced bread. And if you go to, I think just about every country in the world now has sliced bread. Even when we go to Cotonou or to Nigeria, Lagos, we still have sliced bread there. But well, there are some bread over there that you don't have over here. But I look at it, I said, this is who we are. We have the body of Christ. And Christ said, my body, he took the bread and broke it and said, this is my body. And this is what we are. You will never truly understand who you are until you understand bread. Now, do you know why sometimes we as a church, we look very strange? If you look at this bread very well, you see it has two ends that make it whole. There's one here and there's one back there. And one thing I noticed is that to have a slide, no one will go to Safeway and see different kinds of bread and just pick up anyone. If you're like me, you look. Right?
Yes.
Now, somehow, what happens to the church is that some of those who belong to the parts, amen. Somehow don't think. Look. Let me put it on this on their seats while they're not here. Look at it, and then another one decide. Today I'm just gonna go to the club.
Oh, Jesus!
I'm not gonna be there today.
Jesus.
Amen. That's fine. I'm gonna leave that alone. All right. If we didn't have a visitor with us today, we're going to have more plenty of Now, if I keep doing it, now let me ask you, how many of you will go to Safeway and see this bread along with another loaf of bread has the same description, but one is half and the other is full? Which one are you going to take? Oh, you know, every time you stay home and you don't come here, you make our church a half bread. And when people come here and they're looking for a church to unite with, they come in here and say, they look strange. Must be something wrong with them because there's so many parts missing. I don't want to be part of that. And guess what? You know, it doesn't matter how imperfect we are, because you cannot see the imperfection of a piece of bread as long as it is with the rest of the bread. But every time you take the piece of bread out of the whole bread, you see the glaring fault in that bread. So you see, you know, I want to tell you, one thing we don't understand is this, and what messes up the church is that many of us, we came from drugs, we came from prostitution, we came from lying, we came from stealing, we came from backbiting, we came from talking about other people, and God turned us around. And then when we came, we forgot we used to lie. We for God we used to steal. We for, so we want everybody to, you know, everybody come here, you got to be perfect.
You know, I actually grew up in the church, was really saved, and understood what it meant to accept Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior at an early age. Just by growing up in the church, I had this great love for being around God's people. When I moved to California, I knew it was important for me to find a church where I felt like I really belonged. And it took me about 3 years to do that. I visited churches after churches and really didn't find one to fit. But when I came to Village, there was something different. The people were warm and friendly, and the Word of God was being taught here. And after I joined, my life has never been the same. I have family members that I truly can call on whenever I need them, and I know that they're there to support me.
I experienced a whole new life when I accepted Christ. Back in 2006, I was pregnant with my son Mason, who's now 6 years old, and I started coming to Village Baptist Church, being encouraged by different ministries. Fellowship of Believers was one of them, and my sister and my family praying for me and listening to the Word. I then came to accept Christ in my life and become a member of Village Baptist Church. And I tell you, I have made a mess of my entire life, and Village Baptist Church gave me encouragement to and refreshed my spirit, gave me hope that I can grow and move on from the things of the past, and also gave me knowledge and understanding of who God really, really is.
And Village Baptist Church has helped me and learn more about Christ and on what a relationship with Christ really means. When I got saved in 97, and I was in the wilderness for a few years. So, and when I say wilderness, I mean I was not at a, I didn't have a church home. I was saved and believed and loved God, but I didn't have a foundation for teaching. So when I got here to Village, it was a godsend, and I believe that God led me to Village for sound teaching, and I really got to understand what the gospel was and what and how to share the gospel with other people. But it really solidified my belief to know that I was a sinner and I needed Christ in my life. And that's why I accepted Christ. So it's really sound biblical teaching. If it's outside the Bible, we're not going to try to teach it. So I urge you to come and see for yourself.
Hey, welcome back. Hope you enjoyed the video. Now, what you saw was just the tip of the iceberg. We have so many other ministries that we didn't get to talk about. We have a men's ministry, a women's ministry, a high school and young adult ministry, and so many other opportunities for people to get involved. Now, if you want to come visit us, we are one church that meets in two locations. We have one location that meets at 532 South McDowell Boulevard in Petaluma, California. We have a second location that meets at 825 Drake Avenue in Marin City, California. If you want to visit us on the web, our website is villagebaptisthome.org. You can also check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. You can also call our church offices or shoot us an email. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. We hope you enjoyed it, and we hope to see you very, very soon.